What is of good course. Friends we are here with? Well, I owe you bringing Star Wars is P2 for SPL Finals, and the score is like 6-3, because like on the doubles game.
What can I say?
The scooters won.
What can I say? This is fucking bullshit.
So if P2 somehow breaks the stall team, the Tigers win SPL, the score would be 7-3. So while you the Tigers are like trying hard, right? Cause they really wanna like bring it back.
If that's life orb taunt torn.
I don't think I think it's maybe Bandit Zygarde and also the Greninja can potentially get up a spike if it's protein.
Like, I could see it being life orb taunt because, like, what does Assault and Steven do for his team? It's like, so, it's just Peg's offense. Pegzor plus, like, 4 offensive mods.
He's just trying to get a skull burn here, I guess, P2.
But I guess, P2 prepped well for Saw if that's Bandit Zygarde.
Yeah. It looks like Bandit Zygarde.
I didn't even finish making my thumbnail for the black and white game, and the next game already started. So that's probably Scarf and Heligo, right? That's most common. Scarf rocks and Heligo, I guess. Cause this is only rocker.
P2 said, "Alrighty, let's fucking get it." I think he prepped for stall pretty well.
So, I mean, Neligos is only rocker, so he's not getting up rocks versus, unless he's like specs rocks and he forces the Sableye out. By like going, let's say he goes for like power gem and does shit loads to Sableye, okay, helmet packs. And like later on, when he has the Neligo in and, well, I owe you knows it's not, it's specs or something and the Sableye is too low. You will not go in a Sableye, so he could get a Brox that way, but it doesn't really matter because Gamery just kind of defogs, and also he has to be careful what he locks himself into so he doesn't get trapped by Dagi. He gets the burn there, P2 with the Scald, and well, oh, he hits his Will Wish. Nice to see the Scald burn there because nice disgusting stall team.
Okay, so I guess you switch out predicting the recovery.
Not now, you switch. Now you're switching to Bandit Zygarde to pretty much pick off a kill.
It's a bit risky.
I would have done it.
I think Tornadus is a mid ground, but
there was no way he was not recovering there.
Oh yeah, last
no
turn.
Way in hell.
Last turn, yeah, but I don't know why he didn't switch last turn then, yeah. I thought you meant this turn.
Yeah, this turn you should switch. You should switch.
Nah, I'd just click Scald again.
Nah.
I just went Chansey, So this is Rock's chance, he's a standout stall team.
Yeah, like, if he went Bandit Zygarde here, he would have pretty much picked off a kill here.
Bandit Zygarde only does like 45 to Chansey, so he would get Toxic again, which would be really bad for P2 unless he gets a crit.
Actually, no, Torn was better than Torn was better.
Also, Thousand Arrows.
Well, all he's gotta do is, if he gets rocks up, then Bandit Zygarde to hit KOs everything on the field.
Yeah, but he doesn't get rocks up really. Not that easy, at least.
He needs to predict, like, really fucking well.
Yeah.
And I guess, even... I guess, he has pretty safe switches.
Maybe he's
like,
Sableye
is a pretty safe switch.
Because he has the packs.
Nah, but I mean, rocks wise,
just,
like.
I'm just saying, when
they need to wear it down.
Yeah, I'm not talking about rocks wise. I'm just saying, looking at how he can break.
When that Tornadus comes in, things are gonna go down.
Like, he needs rocks 100% because if he doesn't get rocks, he's kind of fucked.
I love you, P2, but I want the tiebreaker.
Wait.
I mean, the Scooters have to win 3 games in a row to
yeah,
make it
to get in tiebreaker.
Yeah. I think the tiebreaker would be played at another day, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so like P2 is like, he doesn't, I guess he could have defog. Yeah, defog is obvious, yeah. But Rox has more PP than defog, so in the long run he gets up Rox, like, will you? Dude, do you look at his avatar, nice schoolboy, and then look at his disgusting team.
Yeah.
It's like a 5-year old. It's like a 5-year old kid that has the power of. I'm not finishing that.
Stalling.
Sentence. Some drug lord. Just kidding. No offense, by the way. I'm just trolling around.
This is gonna be a long ass game. I feel.
I mean, it's gonna be long, but like, if Peter realizes
my man has a pex.
If Peter realizes that he can't not break it, it's gonna be like he's gonna forfeit. I mean, it's already almost midnight here, so it would be nice if they don't take forever. Padlock might have to leave soon. Mans is busy. Mans has a real life. Mans has school. But I don't care if I'm tired tomorrow, so. Worst case, I just don't sleep at all because I gotta record that SBL coverage, right?
Free kill! I have heard about a free kill.
I mean, Thousand Arrows doesn't kill from full.
Thousand Arrows, if it's Bandit, you really think it doesn't kill?
No, it doesn't kill
from full. If it's Bandit, you really think it doesn't kill?
Max defense packs.
Are you sure?
Standard set, it doesn't kill, no. Also,
he's not staying in.
Clefable can switch in if it's defensive.
No way.
It can.
No, there's no. This is adamant banded cycle.
Yes, it.
I guess.
It is not that strong, dude. It is like 40 to Clef.
I guess since Rock's up, Clef can switch.
Are we talking about bold Clef here? Most Clef habits are not bold on stall. But yeah, if it's bold Clef, it can switch in easily. Thousand Arrows only has 16 PP, so that's also a problem. I told you it doesn't kill, so if he gets the burn here, the game is over. Hopefully no burn. Phew.
No burn.
This is a broken one. How did it tank? It sucks a bit.
Close, but no cigar.
I mean, now he goes to Chansey or Clef, depending on his... Like, Chansey just...
Chansey dies.
Chansey? No, there's like 45.
No, Chansey takes two.
Dude, I have to wait. Was a stall. Stall is disgusting.
He's gotta get rocks up to 2-hit KO Chansey and I guess Clef.
Risk
off. Nah. There is always the possibility of patlopping. Critting right here.
Yeah,
100%.
I mean, yeah, if you crit the Chansey gets 2-hit KO out of Clef, but other than that.
Well, I mean, if the Clef comes in, then you just 1,000 arrows a couple more times.
Yeah, you can, but you're getting like PP stole out of 1,000 arrows. Okay, this might get 2-hit KO actually. This is a. Ooh, he gets a min roll. Is he jolly?
That might be jolly.
That did nothing. That was either absolute min or he's jolly.
Just crit here. Just crit here. Come on. Come on.
What the fuck?
Come on. Crit here.
What do you mean?
Do he's it. Already. Do it for Poppy. He's do it for Poppy.
Oh, it's in. It's in.
I mean, he's just knocking off hurricaning, I guess.
He'll hurricane and then knock.
Nah, I feel like he will hard knock. I mean, we just still don't know if it's AV. AV makes a bit more sense, but if we look at the stall matchup, I guess Life Orb would be better. But like, AV is a better pivot in general, obviously.
Like, if this isn't Life Orb, he's gonna have a hard time. So I'm just hoping that it's Life Orb.
Yeah, but if I look at his team, it just makes more sense to be AV.
What does AV even beat for him? He's got Pex for Zard Y and Keldeo.
It's just a solid pivot overall. Like, if you have to take a hit from Ice Beam Greninja, like, Extra Sensory Greninja that beats Toxapex. Like, the standard Greninja set just obliterates. Like, HP Fire kills Scizor, Extra Sensory kills Pex, Ice Beam kills Zygarde. Tong can live Ice Beam with AV and knock off the Life Orb from Greninja and the other expert belt and make it a bit more.
Or he can go Scizor on the Ice check, Beam and threaten it out with a Bullet Punch.
Mm-hmm. I mean, just in general, like, knock off AV Torn is just great utility. It is the Torn Life Orb set.
Yeah,
but Hurricane is going to do Hurricane is going to do like 40, right?
Knock here, come on, knock.
It's Jolly Zygarde Eric just posted the couch.
Yeah, okay, okay.
It does 41 min if you're adamant.
Yeah, okay, okay.
Jolly Band is a bad set. What do you even outspeed?
What do you mean Eric posted the cog? The Smog just shit posted the cog. I guess you're talking about a different chat. Reaver.
I'm talking about the Skype chat.
Yo, OX. Hurricane into Heatwave might have. I mean, Valley would have tried probably to pivot into something from the Heatwave, probably back into Toxapex the next turn on the Heatwave. But yeah, it's still annoying. Okay, that's a good chunk. It's not life or what? That still did a lot.
Yeah.
Is it modest?
I wonder what. It could be like Z move.
Oh, it's Fist Def. It's Fist Def Toxapex. Yeah, it is. It's,
do you think it's
Z-move? It is Z move, yeah. Because I don't think he's Ash. I don't think he's Z move Greninja. And Z move Nihiligo is also not. Like, I think he's Scarf Nihiligo. And Zagat's obviously Bandit.
It's
and
also not common.
Like, Z. Supersonic Sky Strike? You think he's scouting for Supersonic Sky Strike here by going to Chansey or something?
Yeah. That's why I would knock if you have it.
I mean, he probably has to.
Yeah, if you knock and he stays in, you lose nothing from it unless you get burned.
I mean, Tom plus Zayat is like huge in his matchup, but they are nothing.
Damn, this Torn is just staying in and clicking buttons.
If he had like Adamant, I mean, if he stays in, he can get toxic.
No, he's taunting.
Oh, I mean, he can predict that.
No, he's knocking here.
Like, he could have gone to Sableye on a taunt, but I guess that's too risky. Like, if P2 was expecting Star from Value, I don't know why he's not Adamant Zygarde, but maybe he was just trying to make a mid-ground choice.
Okay, so he's stalling out the Hurricanes.
Yeah, I mean, if he gets a confusion and he hits himself... Yup. But too bad that Toxapex is regenerated and just says, I don't care if I take damage. Should have brought Ditto Stall.
So fucking annoying to deal with, I swear to God.
Luna said if
Heat
it was live or it was GG.
I mean, Heatwave here.
Gotten riddled down.
Not knockoff.
Nah, you Heatwave here.
I mean, he's not going.
He probably doesn't have Heatwave.
He doesn't.
I don't know. He could have Sludge Wave,
He should. He should Heat Wave looking at his team.
Ugh, X.
Oh my god.
He's got 10 left.
This is so boring. P2 getting
he's only got 10. Okay, now he's got 9 left. Or no, he taunted. Okay. Dude. He's getting stalled out of his Hurricanes though. This sucks.
I mean, on the bright side, we get more matches if he loses. I mean, more matches that matter, actually, because I don't know if they would still play if the matches don't matter. Some people just say, I don't care. I'm not playing for this. I think Ojama played last week just for fun.
I think he's knock on Torn, and he just hasn't revealed it yet. He wants to save it.
He's U-turn now. So he's not a Solvest then, yeah, when he's taunt, obviously. But, like, earlier I thought he was AV. Like, Ojama played one day after deadline last week just for fun. His game in ADV, I think, yeah. Yeah, someone said CM Sableye just won turn one, kind of. It kind of won, but he could have gone for Hurricane Confusion and for Dark Pulse Flinches or something with Greninja, depending on his Greninja set. Also, Will-O-Wisp can miss, it's always a good move that can miss, and Zygarde can kill Sableye then. Oh boy. There's only one Simon Oyo game left, which is freaking Steve Angelo for the Tigers is playing versus someone afterwards. I forgot who he's playing. He's playing was the Zorn. Okay. But yeah, that will only matter if Willy wins this one, which it looks like he wins pretty much.
Yeah.
Fuck Stoll.
I swear. Word.
Someone said, I love Stoll, it's so fun to face. Nice sarcasm, dude. Race carpet.
You just toss here on the defog, or you can even stealth around.
I mean, even if you defogs, it doesn't accomplish anything. They just go
it's
back.
It's a fucking cancer of cancer, dog.
Knockoff on scissor. Oh, knockoff on scissor would be nice, but there's no way he has knockoff on this specific scissor. When he's defog, U-turn, bullet punch, and roost. Yeah, obvious set is obvious. Knockoff would be nice because Zygarde would two-hit KO the chance he would knocking off a Violite.
I can't believe he's jolly,
dude.
Man.
If he just went for knockoff earlier on the pecs when the chance he came out, then he could have gotten rid of the Violite and then Zygarde was a threat, I guess. But since it's jolly, Clefable probably still walls it. Yeah, pretty much scarf Nihiligo. So he cannot
what
go.
What is Nihiligo doing here?
It's not doing anything. I have no idea.
It's dying.
Maybe he's going for Thunder, maybe, but there's a Dougie and the Chansey, so that doesn't do anything.
I would go in a Dougie.
Yeah, but Dougie gets crit killed. What? Why would you go Dougie?
You just stay
Dougie
in.
He gets crit killed by anything, no Touch Wave or Power Gem or. If it's
because you have no reason not to duck. Yeah, I don't think that Power Gem 2 KOs.
It does. Dougie's defense is like 2.
It covers rocks, it covers Thunderbolt. It covers Power Gem.
I mean, Chansey.
It covers Sludge Wave.
Staying or going Chansey covers everything.
Yeah.
No, I'd go Doug and get rid of that.
You think this is
you
Z
can go
Thunder in the Hill again?
You don't even need Doug that much, except for trapping this.
What they're saying is Specs Thunder.
No, he wants to save Doug
but
for a week.
I feel like
this
has to be Scarf. Like, where's his speed control? I guess he could be Scarf Greninja. This could be Z-move then, but I thought the Z-move wasn't torn like we right now.
Colin said hard Dougie.
P2 is wild, so we actually, yeah. We don't know.
Yeah, I agree. Just harden the Dougie here.
But like, P2's not gonna just let Dougie. Like,
I think he's not gonna go for Electro.
He will go
He predicted the rocks. Ooh, flexing on these boys.
That was a flex play.
I mean, that was a fine play there, because. He doesn't really need
so
to save like healthy, and this is the only potential rocker.
I would have gotten Doug there, TBH. Like, Doug was the better play.
Doug was good in the sense that
oh
you would have trapped.
God, wait, what?
Doug was good in the sense that the Nihiligo just would have gotten
Jesus
trapped.
Jesus Christ.
And if the Nihiligo gets
P2's
trapped,
really out here.
He can just defog after, but this way he keeps off rocks on his side and keeps rocks on P2's side, which is kind of nice. Like, it worked out perfectly, you can't say anything.
It's looking pretty bad for P2.
Yep.
He's lost quite a bit of momentum.
I mean, he's not clicking X, he's trying to win this somehow for his team. I can already imagine that Brof is forced, well, you to bring Stoll.
Okay, so you knock off.
He did that
here
with someone, I think it was Obi. Oh, I don't want to say Forest, but he like told him to use Stoll. But he's the manager, so I guess he can say Forest.
Peck's like, about to get this nice burn.
In an important game, I can kind of understand bringing Stoll, but it's also like super matchup based in RS, right? In Sun and Moon.
Burn.
I mean, if he gets the burns even more over, but it's already over.
Yo, Doc, I think I'm gonna leave.
Bye.
No.
Bye, River. Just kidding.
Bye.
What the fuck is wrong with me?
Later.
Watchers, sub to Dockeridge YouTube.
Shout out to Pat God.
DockeridgeYouTube.com.
Oh, I got some nice tip. We have a turn here where nothing happens. So I want to tell you guys, give you guys some advice about your teams. You always make a backup of your teams, because T isn't called. He just lost all his teams today.
Yes, sadly. I was able to rebuild 2 of them, but
I mean, I have like 500 teams in my builder. I mean, Aura's teams too. and like I would get.
I've lost some ORS teams too. You gotta give me. Yeah. You gotta give me the.
There's like 100 ORS teams, but they're not all good. Some are like complete ass.
All I really want is the Bug Bite, Scizor plus Torn and Nidoking team that everybody.
Oh, that's
uses.
An RNT. That's not hard. You just snatched it from the farm.
That's like my favorite team to use.
You can get that. Can get that by typing in Google. Like that's so easy to get. Okay, so he's going for the confusion here. That's his only play, I guess. And if you see a burn on the packs on a Torn, he can see the X button coming through, but we don't see the burn.
No, I think Torn wants to get burned so it can't get toxic. If that makes any sense.
Oh, come on. Because he just keeps getting Hurricane PP stall. Now he's just going to go back to packs.
Yeah, eventually he will run out of his Hurricanes.
Yeah, I guess does he not have knockoff? Because if he has knockoff, he could maybe go for it.
I don't know what his last move is. It should be Heat Wave, considering that his only way to beat Scizor is HP Fire Nihiligo or HP Fire Grin.
I mean, Toxapex walls Scizor like all day.
It walls it, but
it can't. It can't get trapped by Dagi, I guess. Yeah. Did he knock off? Ah, Said. I think he doesn't have knockoff then.
Probably not. You don't not reveal it for 40 turns.
Nah, I've actually.
What do you think? What do you think his last move is?
I've done that. Like, just don't reveal it for like so long that they don't expect it anymore. When you play versus Storm. So, the chances in 2k range probably a roll. He can go to Clefable here if he doesn't want to lose his chance. Wait, it's not in 2k range. What am I saying? He can just softball.
Yeah, he just
softball. He can just softball. Yeah, my bad. So he has to go for crit basically. Or he can go.
But Outrage.
Outrage doesn't do anything because he just softballs and he goes into Skarmory or Clefable after.
Yeah. I was saying that's the only like potential. Or he could go for an Iron Tail defense drop. But Toxic is way more common.
Iron Tail doesn't do shit, dude. Iron Tail is a snack for Chansey, the rapper. Yeah, like, Zamrock is gonna beat me, obviously. I cannot upload this before him, because...
Oh, it's super power.
He has that
okay.
fast internet from Starbucks. Completely fine with me. Zamrock, the goat chilling at Starbucks.
It's banded superpower Zygarde.
Yeah, but...
And well, you actually scouted for it.
I mean, you can say he scouted for it, but he also... Superpower is also to hit Ferrothorn. Didn't you just say his only way to beat Scizor was Heatwave? And HP Fire and Pex, but he also has superpower to hit... Okay, that was for Ferrothorn, it doesn't hit
Scizor. Superpower does zero to Scizor.
Yeah, I was talking about Ferrothorn because Heatwave. I mixed up the mons. My bad. Because I think the RMT that freaking... The RMT from OB that everyone is spamming on the ladder with Zapdos, Defog, Scizor. I think that team also runs... what am I trying to say here?
Heatwave Zapdos?
Not Heatwave Zapdos. It also runs Superpower Zygarde.
Superpower
Zygarde, yeah. To hit Ferrothorn and... what else does it even hit?
I'm pretty sure...
I guess it's...
Banded Thousand Arrows does... decent damage to Pharaoh anyway.
It does like 35, it doesn't do that much. Or 31, if it's max defense, I think. Nah, a bit more than 31 probably.
Well, you can just 1000 arrows on the switch, 1000 arrows on the leech seed, then act accordingly.
Zygarde is kinda weak, to be honest. Like, the attack stat is weak, but 1000 arrows is such a good move because it has no immunity, so...
Yeah.
That's what Tang... Like, Tangros is everywhere, Nice play. Doesn't do much, but nice play. Yeah, I don't know why he's... I mean, I get that you don't want to forfeit, but like, I really don't see how you can win. I mean, yeah, I guess banking on a choke, that's always the way how... This is just painful for me,
he's
though.
Playing.
P2 as well, I owe you.
Course.
This match has been over like a few turns ago. Toxic.
So oh, he's toxic picks.
Who wins? I just joined.
I mean, well, you win with stall. Like, he has nothing to break stall, pretty much.
Yeah, P2 Stallbreaker is jolly choice banded Zygarde.
I mean, his Stallbreaker is Taunt, Tornadus, which doesn't have life up. It's probably either Z-move Torn or... I don't know. It probably Z-move Torn, yeah. Like, the Torn could have... If it had knockoff, it could have... The Zygarde would have been a threat if it had knockoff on Torn. If he had knockoff. Because the chance you didn't have is a Violet then. Because he brought that in a few times on Hurricane. Like, if he just predicted the chance, he knocked off.
I'm pretty sure the Cliff is in range of a 2-hit KO, isn't it?
Maybe.
I mean, it's jolly, so...
I think it does like 48 adamant.
It's jolly. Already revealed. So it's gonna...
I know.
It's gonna bounce off. Yeah. KK. Yeah, he probably needs Mega Swords, I don't know. I mean, yeah, he can. Do you think he's Iron Tailing here? Okay, never mind. Never mind.
Yeah, superpower.
Okay, that was nice. Yeah, he has superpower, but. Oh. Yeah, okay, so he probably has Outreach and E-Speed. Oh, Toxic, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, probably E-Speed. E-Speed is like. The filler move is the superpower one. Superpower slash Toxic slash Iron Tail.
What does Superpower hit though?
Ferrothorn.
Nothing.
And Chansey.
Doesn't Thousand Arrows do like more? Or not yeah, more, but
it,
like,
it does a decent amount.
It like, doesn't do more.
I'd
but
much rather have
time. I know, yeah.
I really don't know, I would have to ask him. Damn. So he has to go for the crit if he gets the crit.
Remember when he was adamant and that killed?
We might have a game now. Yeah. I mean, you can still crit, like if you're on the defensive you're gonna get crit eventually.
That's why I run EQ and Thousand Arrows.
Yeah, I've actually thought about that. Never tested it. What the fuck?
That sounds like ass.
I mean,
yeah, it's pretty bad.
Now the chance he's out of range.
I don't know why you said it sounds ass, because if you get rid of the ground immunity, you could put.
Yeah, but
work.
Toxic is so nice.
I mean, he has superpower. Like, if you have superpower, you might as well want Earthquake. Nah, I don't know. It is probably specific for something that is weak to. Is there some steel type that doesn't get hit by... Nah, steel types
are good. Wait, maybe superpower hits Beware. The more you know.
Thousand Arrows does more, because it doesn't actually, like, hit him.
Yeah, Thousand Arrows does about the same, or maybe a little bit more. Also, no, it doesn't hit... It's not for Beware, definitely not. Nice troll.
Does Thousand Arrows affect Fluffy or not?
It probably doesn't affect Fluffy. Steve Angelo joined Bob. Ooh, my computer's about to die. Let me plug that charger. They call me Tim, Steve Angelo. Okay. This game is so boring, I don't even want to commentate on it. So yeah. Just Chansey gets natural cure. And he's probably gonna U-turn into Pax here because he doesn't want to get the scissor, let the scissor get burned. Like, this is a wisp slash knockoff or slash recover for the Sableye.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, I want to look at the black and white game that I'm uploading. It's at 79%, let me actually... Okay. My black and white game is almost uploaded, but I didn't even make the thumbnail yet, because... This freaking game popped up. I mean... It was just a safe play by Wellu, he doesn't really lose much. Clicking Wisp.
Yeah. Wait.
They call me Stall. If you have like okay or decent matchup with Stall like this, you just don't have to make plays.
Maybe he'll stay in as he gets Z-Hurricaned.
I mean, it's not gonna... He can go Pex or Chansey.
It's probably gonna do like 70.
He can go Chansey because...
Yeah.
He has never clicked knockoff unless he really bluffed it until now.
Yeah, I thought he'd be like Heat Wave or something.
Yeah, that makes sense. He has to go for the confusion here. Gets a miss, which is something. If that hit, it would've been all over probably.
Okay, if you're knockoff, this is the turn.
No, he doesn't have it.
Dude. He's really weak to Ferrothorn, only has like...
Yeah, that's why he has superpower on Zygarde.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah,
it should be Heat Wave Torn, though. I'm guessing HP Fire and Nihiligo also.
Gren.
Yeah, Gren too.
Man, ask. Man's fidgeting at the ass that I'm recording.
There goes another
one. Why did he say? I'm not reading that out, but he just said, what the fuck? Why did he say that? Tell your fans that P2 dot dot dot, you can read it yourself.
Oh, you better read it.
No, I don't gotta read. Isn't Zemov recording this too? He said he was recording this.
Yeah.
But he's like, nah, this is a 2 hours match, I'm out here. Just kidding. Who's Destiny Unknown? What you saying? Dude, I gotta concentrate on the game. Stop irritating me, chat. Just kidding. The game is nothing going on. Boring as fuck. So, like, he's almost out of Hurricane.
Yeah, he's only got 5.
Which is his only way to hit Toxapex, Sableye decently hard, and he misses another one.
Of course.
Oh, this is
looking like a hard X now. Like, it's actually... it's looking over.
I just hope we see a really nice game between Steve Angelo and the Thorn after.
Let's go.
I just don't want to see stall anymore. It feels like the ladder. They call me. I cannot even break 1700s because I face stall every game, and I'm not trying to bring a stall C team. As Sorry would say, just bring SmackDown Landers with rocks.
Yeah, Adamant Earthplate Lander. I mean, that's all you need.
SmackDown Lander is amazing, but. The problem is if you run offensive landers, you cannot run defensive landers, which is kind of necessary in this meta.
No, yeah, gravity landers.
Like, gravity landers also fire. I have a Trosco team with that, which has a Pheromosa, so I have to replace the Pheromosa with something, and then I will use it in a life for sure.
Yeah. I mean, maybe if he DCs, he'll win.
I mean, it's SPL final, so I completely understand that he's not forfeiting, but... There's literally no win condition,
That's the fighter's spirit.
I mean, I've done the same on the ladder when it was OLT. I was playing that guy for like 2 hours when he had matchup with Stall, and I was trying to break through somehow. I was hoping to have him choke or something, and he didn't choke. But I just... I was like, you're using Souls, so I will make you pay for this. You have to play through this for 3 hours.
Dude, nasty plot Togekiss. Nobody ever runs it.
I had SD Gliscor and Mens just PP stalled me. I mean, nasty plot Togekiss, yeah, but... Thumbstall runs Zapdos and shit. And also, Earthslash can miss. And it doesn't even get the flinch that often, at least when I use it.
Man. The only thing you really have to flinch is like Clef, and then the other things you can just set up
Chansey, on. Chansey, you can't really set up on because it has Toxic, and Heal Blade only has 8 PP. So you kind of, so how you play it, you want a Nasty Plot, and then you switch out onto Steel type on a Chansey because it will Toxic.
You just Nasty Plot all the way up, and then you Heal Blade Roost, and then you don't take that much from Toxic.
Yeah, but they just spam. If you Nasty Plot up to +6, while you're Toxic, and they spam S-Toss, you're going to be so low. Oh, you might even be dead.
I guess it could be annoying.
Dude, what is this Tornadus's force?
I mean, yeah, Nasty Plot Togekiss is great versus Stall. It's like... I don't know how it was in Gen 7, but it was great in Gen 6. but it's still not a guaranteed win. It's like a 70% win, maybe.
I see. It's a 40% win.
Because it can miss.
60%, a 60% win, I mean.
Yeah, I'm just like... kind of. Got a factor in that Erslich can miss and stuff.
Yeah. That's why you run wide lens.
Wait, on Togekiss, you need the leftovers, kind of. I mean, you will get knocked off by the Sableye if you... I feel like you have to play it really smart so that you don't lose your item with Togekiss versus Stall.
Yeah.
I mean, substitute Togekiss could work versus Stall, Reap. So, like, you don't even... If you make like Togekiss with enough HP so that they don't break your sub, so that Seismic Test doesn't break your sub, and then you can...
Yeah.
Set up all of a chance and you don't get knocked off by Sableye.
I can't wait for Low Pony to come out, because Stall is gonna be like...
I mean, how is Low Pony beating Toxapex?
Power up punch.
I mean, yeah, but you still have to avoid the Scald Burn, and they still have a plus one hit, then you get Toxic or Scald Burn.
How much does plus one return do to it?
Plus one return? Toxapex, if it's max defense, maybe like 55, maybe. Like a Head Calc. Also, Stall has Unaware Cliff, so they can just make it a bit more defensive if they wanna.
Yeah, but it's kind of like a threat.
Yeah, it is a threat, but because if they make the Clef more defensive, they become weak to Manaphy. Like Manaphy gets checked by Chansey. So I don't know why this is a video talking about Stall, but not talking about the game.
Cause there's nothing to talk about.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Oh God, Mance predicted a taunt. Oh yeah, earlier he made a flex play. He went on to Sableye. On an Illegal when the Sableye was burned.
On the Stealth Rocks?
Yeah, on the Stealth Rocks. The Sableye was at 60, so if he attacked it, the Sableye would have been super low. Was it like 60?
Yeah, that's a choke. That's not a stunt play, that's a choke.
I mean, he didn't really need the Sableye healthy, and the Illegal was the only...
He hasn't even used the Sableye.
He knew that Illegal was...
He's just been switching between Chansey and Pex.
Illegal was the only potential rocker, so there's... Yeah.
Stall's fucking... Dude... It's like busted, dude, but it's like so matchup. If P2 just brought like one good stall breaker, like a good one as in maybe Adamant Band or like knockoff Torn.
I mean,
yeah.
There's stuff like Hooper and others that just
like Hooper
that would 6-0 stall if Dagi didn't exist. There is Zatwai plus Dagi, Screech Dagi to trap the Chansey with. Like, you either kill a Chansey with a Reversal or with a Tectonic Rage or something. Or you just bring it super low with Earthquake and never let it heal. I hope my computer is working fine, like the recording, because I have a Photoshop open in the background. Like, sometimes when I have too many programs open, it crashes. Wow, we had turn 73 and it's... Oh, good God. How many minutes has it been? 38 minutes, okay. I feel like we're gonna be here for like 20 more... 30 more minutes or 20 and then he's gonna forfeit. But I gotta get the coverage, because I can't just...
Nah, he's almost out of hurricanes. It'll be over.
I can't just stop in the middle of the recording. Like, I recorded AB hours as Telly, right? Only like... 30 or 20 minutes, but I was up for the entire game. It was like, it ended at 6 a.m. my time. That was like when I started my YouTube.
You notice P2 hasn't got a Scald Burn?
Kinda. Yeah, I think he burned the Sableye, that's it. But I think he heal belt that off. I didn't even pay attention. If he burned the Sableye off. Maybe I'm hallucinating, because this game is too much for me. Yeah, he doesn't get a Sculpin. Oh yeah, he got a Sculpin early in the Chansey, but Chansey just has natural cure, and it's called Burn being nerfed. Chansey just says, I don't care. I mean, yeah, well, he is like playing it fine, but it's not really hard to play it fine because you have the matchup, like, I feel. I mean, you still have to consider that it's SPL.
It's
SPL finals.
This isn't even important.
Well, he has all the pressure on him if he loses this team. K can't win anymore, so I guess this is easier said than done. I mean, I would feel the pressure. Dude, I would click X on the lobby chat so fast if I would play in like a tournament like this. Mans are talking so much. Like some people like PDC, they just chill in the chat during their game sometimes. Dude, I want to see Padlop in Espia, and then when he hexes his opponent, the chat, Padlopping, like 500 people say it. Can't wait to upload my new show on live with Sorry and Padlop.
Padlop has actually figured out how to be good at Pokemon.
Yeah, I know.
All you gotta do is just hex. It's so easy. Like, you can never lose if you just...
Oh my god, stop flexing. I mean, that was obviously the best play you could make, because Sableye doesn't get 2-hit KO'd from Nihiligo unless it's like Specs. I don't even know if Specs would 2-hit KO. Nah, probably Specs might. Yeah, probably.
Oh, he brings the Greninja out.
Oh my god, flex. Go for Bandit low kick, friend. Do it. I mean, this is probably...
I don't even think that kills.
Bandit would kill.
It'd probably do like 42.
Low kick does like 40 if it's life orb or 38, but if it's Bandit, bop. I know Gangshot does like 40-ish with life orb. But that's only the that's the Greninja that only runs 4 attack, I think. The Greninja that runs more attack probably blows it away. Fight Z low kick. I mean, I think he's just going in Toxapex here.
Yeah.
I mean, he can also softball if he
He can go Sableye on a spike.
Going Toxapex just ensures that he doesn't get like he avoids risking the chance of getting crit.
Hey, if he goes Sableye on a spike.
I mean, that would be fire, but I don't think he has to make.
I'm just trying to see some like plays. This is awfully boring.
I mean, I don't know why it's so bad.
Yeah, I don't think he can lose this game, honestly.
It's turn 80, dude. It's not even that long. I don't know what I would have done if I had you... If I had you what in the call during the ABR game, because I was like, huh. Woo! Nice double switch. Ooh. Did you see NJMP's video about it? That was funny. I gotta link it to you later, if you didn't see it already.
He went save on a potential spike. That's what's up.
Yeah, I mean, he was predicting either Gangshot or low kick or spike. So yeah, you made the right suggestion there. Shoutouts to you, the T. It's T, bruh.
Oh, me. Just it's T, bruh. Unstoppable, aka the greatest, aka Young Baselord 21 Savage.
Dude, it's midnight. Hurry up. Deadline is in 5 hours and 45 minutes. I don't know. I give P2 like 30 or 40 more turns maybe.
Yeah. It's looking bleak.
Dude, my eyes are starting to hurt. I've been on Smogtus the entire day. So I don't miss an SBL game. But I think I missed one or two. Yeah, I missed the doubles game and I'll miss the Gen 2 game because I didn't want to narrate it. I didn't miss it, but I just watched it without. And then RBY. Oh yeah, RBY best of 3. Shoutouts to Lapras and Snorlax. Insult probably left because he died because it's so boring.
He'll probably U-turn or spike here.
I mean, I don't think he has U-turn. I think he's
Well, it could.
Spikes HP fire, extra sensory, and then ice beam or hydro pump.
You think it's protein ninja?
Yeah, I think it's protein. Spikes makes a lot of sense.
It does. It could be spikes.
I mean, he has a defogger, so spikes is kind of counterproductive, I guess. So he tries to bring the scissor on a chance. Does he get it correct? Okay. He can roost here. If he gets scald burned here, that would speed up the match. And
I don't think the burn would matter because he's not really dealing.
I mean, the burn matters in the sense that he gets worn down even more.
Yeah.
But yeah, he doesn't get the burns.
I'll be right back. I gotta go piss.
Man's roosted again. He's gonna get burned eventually, right? Yep, there it is. X. Yeah, like, I can appreciate that you're fighting for your team, B2, but oh, you're not winning this. I'm sorry, dude. Yeah, if you are hyping up, give us Steve voices. The Thorn. It's Scooter's fault if they play stall. Oh, yeah, Gemma wants to play. Dude, my black and white game already uploaded. So he just went for defog on the Sableye. Oh nice, Aim made a video how to be better in tournaments. How to do better in tournaments. That's pretty interesting, I'll watch that later. Even though like Tombas already made a video like this, how to be better. How to get better in tournaments, which is a really nice okay. One. I can definitely what's the word? I don't know the English word for it. I have the German word in my head, but I don't know the English word. I can definitely suggest that video by Tombas where he talks about how do we get better at tournaments or how to prep in tournaments.
How to scout your opponent's replays, etc.
I mean, yeah, I'm not gonna talk about it because I don't think I got the knowledge, but this game is so boring, let's actually talk about it a little bit. So let's say your opponent uses stall a lot, but you don't want to just bring a full stall counter team that loses to every other matchup. You want to like bring a team that you comfortable using. Definitely, like, if you're new to the tournament scene, that's like definitely nice. So you have to be comfortable with your team. And what was the other thing? I had another thing that I wanted to say. God, I can't think. This fucking game killed my brain cells. Just kidding. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that to someone else. I'm not gonna talk about I lost my train of thought. I mean, yeah, Tornadus gets regenerated, but the scissor got like burned when you left. Like right when you left, the scissor got skull burned. Let me see. Yeah, okay, this video is on private, amazing. Because I haven't added a thumbnail yet. I'm not trying to upload a video without a thumbnail. That's just, no. That's not good. Yeah, PDC still has to play for OST. And 10 to 40 minutes. Okay. That's actually bad, because at the same time, there might be Steve Angelo versus the Sorn, which I have to record Steve Angelo versus the Sorn, because if Steve Angelo brings this home for the Tigers, that's going to be Fire Flames. Because that's actually the last game I want to record. I'm not going to record the AVD Ojama game probably because I ain't got the knowledge. Maybe if I get someone in call and they got some knowledge. Or maybe if T wants to record with me this Gen 3 game. I mean, Gen 3 is kind of fun, but I just have no idea how to commentate it. There's no team preview, there's no... Oof. I don't have an idea what all this stuff does.
Yeah, I probably won't be in that video.
I mean, Gen 3 is pretty cool if you know how to play it and all that goodness. I mean, it's always nice to like change up, learn something new. Cause I've watched, I think it was Aim's Little Cup. It was Aim's Little Cup video yesterday. I was like watching through his old YouTube videos that I all missed because I was uploading SP like a freak, like crazy last weeks. So I missed some videos. Like I usually watch every Pokiem video. Shout out to Pokiem. And then I was like, oh, that's actually not that boring, Little Cup. So, but yeah, the Little Cup.
Yeah, Little Cup looks pretty lit.
The Little Cup.
They just banned Vulpix, I'm pretty sure. They had a suspect test. I believed it was banned. That thing was like
broken. I know there was Bell a Sprout. Suspect, but I don't know the result. Also, the Little Cup video that I recorded today was pretty ass narration, but yeah, it was still a fun battle for sure. Shoutouts to Scarf Drillbur. Yeah, also, I started playing like Monotype Random Battles yesterday for fun versus friends, so I just realized it's like fun to switch it up from time to time, because usually I only play OU. And I think there's UUPL, UU Premier League coming up, and pretty sure they bid a lot of money on Pokiem. And he said in the chat for fun, don't bid that much on me, you know I got hacks in SPL, something like that. But yeah, I think that's gonna be pretty interesting, because I'm actually not that much into Sun and Moon UU at the moment, and Sun and Moon Premier League will be amazing to like for me to see some high level gameplay and learn something about the tier, but I actually don't know when the tournament starts. I think should be in a few weeks. And I've also heard there might be a overused Premier League after World Cup in summer or something like that. But yeah, I'm pretty much hyped for all that stuff. I'm hyped, super hyped for World Cup in summer when hopefully Metagross and Greninja, or at least Metagross gets banned soon, and Faramosa hopefully gets banned. From what I've seen in the forums, most people want to vote ban Faramosa. Which is definitely the right decision. I'm not trying to explain that. You can watch my other videos. Actually, you can just read the... I read out ABR's, Blunder's opinion, etc. in my suspect test video about Faramosa. And I gave some extra information. Like, I was on Pokegames video the other day, like 1 or 2 weeks ago in the comments. And there was like someone... Why would you run Hyper Beam on Faramosa? And then I put that nice calc. Hyper Beam from Faramosa does like 85% to Toxapex, right? If it's max Spadef, you only do like 80 or 78 maybe? 70-ish, but you still 2-hit KO. Like, Toxapex is pretty much the best check to freaking Faramosa, and that thing gets blown back by Hyper Beam. Z Hyper Beam at plus 1. Equivalence Faramosa is stupid mon, but yeah, I don't know, I guess I should focus on the battle a bit more. Toxapex once again toxic the Chansey, but Natural Cure just says, I don't care, I'm switching out. I'm getting that toxic healed, and I just, Chansey got the rocks back up, and so this is gonna be, take a while, but the rocks are gonna be up eventually, cause rocks has more PP than Defog. Scizor doesn't beat Chansey 1v1, so he almost gets up rocks again. Okay, so he passes a wish into Chansey. Keeping Chansey and Clefable healthy is still important, so he doesn't lose to Bandit Zygarde.
Yeah, Will.IU is playing this pretty well, I guess. For it being stall. Like, all his mons are at 100% right now.
You know what's fire in like, Auras OU? When you, like, played stall and the opponent had a Medicham, right? And you had the Weavile stall, the ABR team, right? And then some guy on the ladder, I watched him, I don't know if it was user, I'm so sorry, lol. But it was someone, I watched him ladder. And they went hard. He went hard Weavile on the Ice Punch. Because he knows the opponent never high jump kicks when you have a Mega Sableye. And it was so funny. And then he's like, that's the only way to play stall, like hyper offense, it's way more fun, that's what the guy said. And I also play stall like that sometimes, but I did that even before the guy said that. Like in Auras, I played stall like that. Now my way of...
What do you do, What do you do if you hard Weavile on the Ice Punch? Would you pursue or would you knock?
I mean...
Or would you crash? I would
probably crash because it kills the Medicham. But if they have bullet punch, you look like a young fool.
Yes.
I don't remember. I think he actually pursued the Medicham and he switched out, so he flex master 360 on this guy.
Flex. Hey, he's really out here.
So he's gonna go Sableye again, right? I'll talk to Pax.
Flex master 360.
I'm not trying to get a spike on his side. But the Greninja didn't reveal anything yet, so it could also be Ash.
Yeah, he's been doubling. Like, so he could be Ash and just didn't want to reveal the Ash with the U-turn.
Ash gets like, walked by Chansey / Clef.
Yeah, and that would be maybe why he's been doubling to not reveal what could potentially wall this Mon. Or, I mean, Chansey's at 100, so is Sabe, so you can just go Sabe.
I mean, I really get that you're trying to play for the choke, but I'm actually getting tired, because... 1 a.m. in 30 minutes here. Recording is probably 1 hour soon. Let me check. Yeah, it's 55 minutes. RIP. I hope I still have some brain cells left for the next game. I'm just kidding, but it's kind of annoying.
This is going to be a very boring upload.
No. We did some fun jokes. Kind of, not really. I would do some funny edits with some juicy music where he like flexes, where he brings in the saber on the rocks. But I did one shot on live that is not up yet, but I have finished rendering it. And I put so much work in that shit, and then I wanted to render and it says it takes fucking 25 hours to render. I don't know what is wrong with my computer. Usually when I render it takes like 1 hour. And a video that has the same length, for some reason, took 25 hours, just because I made some edits. Like, my program decided to, yo, that's poor Darkwish, you have to wait. Thankfully, I had a second computer that I could render on, so I could still record on my computer. Because if I render and record at the same time, that's not good, that would, like, crash. We can actually change up the track that I have in the background. I got some Zelda in the background at the moment. You want some Team Skull remix videos? You want some Team Skull? Yeah, let's listen to some Team Skull. Guzma Lidar, Team Skull. Let's go. I've actually had this track playing earlier too in the RS game where we had BTB and T in the call, where it wasn't.
Will I be able to hear the music?
Oh no, you will hear the music in the video, but no, I have earphones in. You don't hear the music now.
That's whack.
If I don't have earphones in, it would actually be completely bad, because like my OBS is recording the music from the computer itself, and it's recording my voice that comes into the microphone, and if I make the music on loud, it would be double recorded. Like the computer would record the music, and the music would also be in the microphone, so it would be really really bad sound. So. Where you can't hear the music. You can hear some music on your own. What you got. Someone said I wish Estos could crit. So he wants this game to end is what I'm probably what I'm reading out this. I've seen this standard stall team a bit on the suspect ladder, right? And if you guys want my honest opinion, I don't think this team is that good anymore as it once was. The meta has kind of adapted to this. You see it's probably not super common, but I guess it's just my friends that use the Smackdown Earthblade Landris, which is kind of really good versus stall, and the combination of that and when the Zygarde is decent. Me and BTB still lost to Stalin alive. RIP. Even though we had both those mons, but we got frozen. But yeah, let's not talk about that.
Your Zygarde got frozen?
My sister got frozen. And then we lost to the Curum, because it was like Bolt Curum. It's this RMT from this one guy. Max is going to watch my video and be like, I beat you.
Yeah, I know the Curum said it's like no.
It's like bold, yeah.
Crash
like Curum is like super annoying to face. Substitute. It's a cool set. I like it more offensive though. The set Envy used is like modest with substitute. Roost, Ice Beam, Earth Power, yeah. Yeah, it's the same set like then on the stall team. Well, as on the Stoughton, good god, I cannot even grandma anymore. Too late here. So yeah, what else, why is this team? Oh yeah, I've seen me and T have laddered for fun, and we have seen some Z move Keldeo, which blew us away. That shit was funny.
It pretty much just obliterates this guy's stall team.
Oh, that's the crit. We're making progress. He's gonna protect you, which means Zayat has to waste another PP. And he only has 5,000 arrows left after protect. Okay, I gotta speak a bit lower. Someone is sleeping upstairs. I mean, if they fall out bad, I'm gonna say it's not my fault. Because that boy just crit it, so I had to get kinda excited. I mean, P2's only way of winning is Hex at this point. Like, it's just how it is, right? And I don't want SPL finals to end with a Hexy game. I know Stall is annoying and, like, this might not be super interesting to watch, but I just want to see that next game. And, like, if the next game doesn't matter, it's just, the fire is out. Like, no one wants to see that anymore. But the hype is there for the next game if Wellio wins this. The score would be 6-4 if Wellio wins. So then the Thorn would have to beat Steve Angela after. And Ojama is playing versus Jabba the Griffin. So Ojama would have to win his game too. So the score would be 6-6 and we would get a tiebreaker then if all those scenarios happen. Or if that scenario happens, however you want to call it. My English is bad. Sometimes it's bad. It's actually not that bad. But I could use some new vocabularies. I feel like I use the same words too often. That's fine. I don't know what P2 is thinking about. Is he thinking about if he could double out to save 1,000 arrow PP? I don't think he can afford to make that play. I mean, doesn't he kind of just get a kill here? But the thing is, he has too little 1,000 arrows left to win with this Zygarde. Like, Wellio is obviously protecting here, there's no doubt in my mind. He didn't really protect yet, that would be really odd if he didn't have protect on his clav. Do you see this, T? I'm wild, I'm still narrating this.
Yeah.
Man's
just kinda chill.
Man's already fell asleep. Yeah, I don't know what P2 is analyzing here. Like, let's say if he loses the clef, clef would open up. What would it open up? Nothing really. Ash Greninja still gets walled by Chansey. This is tough, dude. Like, even if he kills the clef, that would open up that Wellio doesn't have heal bell anymore. So I guess P2 could try to get some skull burns here and there, but Chansey just has natural cure, so doesn't really care about that.
It just has natural cure.
Getting rid of Skarmory plus Clefable would be pretty much nice for P2. But even then he wouldn't win. Like, even if he gets one kill with Zygarde, he just gets revenged by Dougie. Like, now he just, yeah, okay, he doesn't protect there. So now he can just revenge it with Dougie. Yeah, I don't know why I said that he's gonna protect for sure. Revenging this with Dougie is completely fine play. That was pretty much the only thing that Wellio had to fear, and you can see a U-turn from Greninja here if it's Ash. Chance he's gonna come out here. Nah, the chance is at 66. I guess he's going Toxapex or Chansey. Oh. He said probably game. Thankfully, you came to that conclusion, because I'm not trying to sit here for 2 more hours. I mean, we're kind of making progress. It's not 6 versus 6 anymore, it's 5 versus 5 now. Yeah, makes the Pex play. Okay, T the god with the prediction. So it's Ash Greninja, okay. Decelebrate? No, it's not Decelebrate.
No, that's not a set.
I mean, it is a set, but not...
Not with Water Shuriken.
Yeah, if he got the Ash Form off, he could have actually won this with flinching the Sableye off. I mean, flinching the Chansey. So it's obviously smart to not stay in with the doggy. Going hard Chansey would have been fine too, besides a potential crit. Like, Toxapex was overall the best play, as in the sense that you can just scald what he, if he's Ash or Protein, and you can just regen off the damage if he has extra sensory on, and he goes for it on this specific turn for some reason. Spiking there would have been a hot play, but he obviously doesn't have spike. And he could have spike.
Could be spike ninja like this.
Yeah, some Ash Greninja run spikes. Because like Ricardo said in his newest video, Tapu Fini is not that common anymore. So you can... Like Tapu Fini always just defox on Ash Greninja, but it's not that common. So spike is kind of cool. It's kind of like it's between U-turn Ice Beam and...
It's also good for like forcing defogs on Fini to bring him on in and whittle something.
Like on Ash Green you run like Dark Pulse, obviously. I don't know why I'm trying to tell this, like people who watch this video know this. But yeah, Hydro Pump, Dark Pulse, Water Shuriken, then it's between U-turn Ice Beam or Spikes, whatever you want to run.
Surf over pump if you're real.
Nah. What do you mean if you're real? If you're real, you hit your hydro pump. Yeah, I don't know what P2 is probably working on, his strategic game plan that doesn't exist. I don't know. Like, I'm not trying to shit talk him, obviously, but I don't
understand. It sounds like shit talking.
What? Did it sound like shit talking? Like, I just don't see how he can win, like...
Nah, I could.
I don't know how...
It's just facts.
I don't know how often I have to... Oh, he's not going, he's Spikes. Is he, like, expert build? I mean, this can win if he gets,
It's probably Spikes. It's probably Spikes Mystic Water.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Darius used that. This can win if he gets, like, 4 flinches on the cliff, on the Chansey.
Yeah. Or like 5 flinches.
Crit flinch, where? Ah, there we go. That did jack shit, good god. Flinch. X.
There's no justice in these streets.
I mean, you already got the crit on the clef. A nice crit, that doesn't even do anything though. Nice min roll, 26. Well, you're just saying, nah, I'm not trying to get flinched, I'm spamming recover.
Yeah.
Okay, now he's trying to get the skull burn. I'll just get chip damage off. They're really trying to make this as long as Televerse's ABR. I'm just kidding, obviously. Televerse's ABR was way longer. God, why does he keep flinching? But even that doesn't do anything for him. Like, he's probably gonna be out of Dark Pulse, double flinch, King's Rock Greninja in the cut. If he got the triple flinch, that would have been wild. He still would have gotten wild by Chansey anyway after.
I'm already on turn 144.
Oh, I'm 139. I'm not skipping now, gotta watch through the entire thing. I'm on 141, Mans is still trying to flinch. The Toxapex has 9 recovers left still. Bop. Okay, Scald doesn't really burn that much this game. It hasn't burned that much. It gets a crit and a flinch. Bop. Well, you're gonna go recover here, obviously. Yep. Doesn't get the flinch there. Okay, I'm on 145.
He's got six or.
Wait, get another flinch. Yeah, he has like 6 left.
He's got 4 left.
Okay, you already went turn ahead. 2.
Now 3. And he's burned. So
this is somewhat depressing to watch because he in the chat. So yeah, don't watch this game on a day that you don't feel good, because you're gonna feel even worse. Just kidding.
Yeah.
I mean, if you watched it until this point, I don't even...
Save this game for a rainy day.
Okay, you finally got the burn. I mean, this game is just for the SBL freaks out here who are really trying to catch every Sun Moon on your game. Dude, I think my computer just lagged. The dark bolt and the recover animation, they're going so slow. My computer said I've had enough of this game. I'm not even kidding, it's going so slow. Ninja dies to burn, okay. Like... Is he gonna defog here or roost? Roost, okay.
He defogs, but...
Oh, Steve Angelo's playing in 2 minutes. Oof.
Oh, yes.
We out here.
Let's, I wanna see Thorn catch this dub.
I mean, I want Steve Angelo to win, but I also wanna see the juicy tiebreaker, so I'm not really sure.
I like the way that the Thorn has played this SPL.
The song plays aggressive, I like it, yeah. I mean, it's really hard for me which team to root for, but it's like a little bit more rooting for the Tigers. Why did he say Abelanus is pretty hard? Why did he
I wish the Pokemon community was larger than it is. Like, SPL should be so much bigger than what it is. Like Zamrock said in his upload the other day that, like, this community doesn't get as much love as it should.
When did he say that?
It was in his upload about SPL.
Prediction?
The finals predictions. Oh, right. Yeah, he was...
Yeah, I watched that video, but it was a 4 a.m. my time, and I watched it, so I would probably forgot what he said. He really was work up Greninja, is he not kidding? This guy is packing heat in SPL finals. This guy, give me that team. Give me that team, I want to use that Greninja in the show on live for my heat series. Work up Greninja.
Dude, I've thought about that.
There's shit. No way, he could have worked up on the turn that the Toxapex run for recover, why didn't he do that?
He didn't bring it.
Oh.
He didn't bring work up.
I thought he said, I wish I could have unleashed it, so I thought he brought it. Whatever, even if you brought it, or if you didn't bring it, or if he's just trolling.
What would it be? Water Shuriken, Dark Pulse, Workup, and then, like, a physical move, or... I guess it'd just be another special move. Pump.
I don't know, dude.
Probably Pump. That way you get the plus one, and you can switch up moves.
Man said save Dark Rich memory on his computer. I mean, my computer is fine, dude, like... I got that nice 600 gigabyte. And I also delete, like, some uploads. I don't keep all. I delete a lot
of
them.
Who is Markov?
It's an old gen player, and he's pretty decent. He played in Smoktus earlier, and... I faced him on a ladder in Auras, and he beat me. Got blown back. I was pretty bad in Auras. I'm still not the best. I'm more like the type of guy, I probably said this in an earlier video already. I enjoy watching high level games or just games for fun. I can play pretty decent, but I'll just choke from time to time, so I never really got too much into tournaments. I should do it, like people have told me I should get on tournaments and it's fun. I'll do it sooner or later. I'm just not sure which tournament I will play next. Like I've played one.
I'm trying to make OLT this year.
Ooh, that's gonna be hard, dude. They're gonna be tried. I played like a clan war with friends and Facebook, and I choked in my finals game, so I kind of have like a bad... How do I say it in English? Bad memory?
Like, not even winning OLT, like, just try to make
it. Yeah, of course, yeah, of course, I'm just gonna try OLT for fun, like, just ladder for fun, like... I mean, even though OLT, there's most of the time 2 or 3 or 4 teams that just get spammed all over the ladder. So you just have to see team those 3 or 4 in one team and you're good to go. And Petlob lucked out last year. Somehow he qualified for OLT. Because, like...
Yeah, nice jealousy.
Dude, someone said sub in OB for the Thorn. That would be fire. like Padlop didn't get much stall on the ladder last year. Otherwise, like Padlop's teams don't beat stall. I don't know why I just revealed that. That's not new. Like, you guys should know that Padlop teams lose to stall. Yeah.
Chansey just walls everything.
Shoutouts, stall counter tank jump. Dude, I had like an entire water bottle when this game started, and it's gone. It's 1.5 liters.
Dude, I'm saying I got a 32 ounce white cherry Powerade, and that bitch gone.
Man P2 is like, yeah, win condition. Man's falls out his chair, or someone cuts his internet. I'm not giving up.
I like the warrior spirit, don't get me wrong. But I don't think he can win. He's even getting stalled out.
Which turn are you? I'm at 172.
173. He has two roosts left on the scissor.
Yeah, I'm 173. I mean, like I said earlier, Chansey just gets off the rocks every time he defogs. Chansey almost out of softballed. So that little pink blob got a bit tortured. It got beat down multiple times. And it almost can't recover anymore. It's almost out of softball. My water bottle almost fell down.
He doesn't even need his Chansey anymore.
I mean,
now the Scizor can't roost no more. This game, it's
wrap. Been over. Like, 150 turns ago or something like that. Why did he say rude? What happened? Did someone trash her?
No, he stealth rocked on the defog on Scizor, I guess. Like, just made a
basic prediction. Scarface said, well, you didn't choke, that's impressive. He's improving at an...
Yeah, did Zamrock and predicted Will IU to choke this game
He's
away.
Improving at an alarming rate. I mean, yeah. I don't know. Just because he... Oh, do we see a skill pass on his Sky Strike? Inferno Overdrive. Ooh, nice chip. So it was Heat Wave, like you guys said. Like you and some... I think it was Insult, right? Was it Padlop? It was Padlop and Insult and you... You all thought had Heat Wave.
Yeah, it was pretty obvious. To help out as Nihiligo. Especially since he's not Protein Ninja.
Yeah, I mean, I was just going off the fact that he had HP Fire and was Protein Ninja, so I wasn't 100% sure if he was Heat Wave. But you guys got me. You read his team like you're the Jesus. So now we're going for Heat Wave Burns, I feel you. Dude, the best show, no, not the best show in life, but the fire show in life is gonna come up next days. I feel like I'm drunk because my eyes just hurt from like looking at the screen for hours. I can't think anymore. I remember recording Uber Stall versus Stall with Padlop for like 2 or 3 hours. That was funny as fuck. Let's go crit. I mean, not that it changes the outcome, but at least you would bring the score down to 4-0. I'm just kidding, dude. I don't even know what I'm saying. I feel like I'm on some drugs. It was Choice Scarf Rocks. Yeah, pretty obvious.
Scarf Rocks and Hiligo. This man is really out here.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, P2 got some little hacks, but he also got a lot of hurricane misses. This Toxapex might also be out of recover soon. Has 4 left, okay. How many hurricanes does he have? Oh, he has 0 hurricanes left. RIP.
Now his attacks.
Steve Angelo's ready since 30 minutes. His opponent is not ready. He says he will wait till 5 a.m. if he has to. 5M is in 4 hours. D'Angelo is in the same time zone as me. He's in Germany. Shout out to Germany. And yes, EB is also German because he's like, yeah, he's the manager from the scooters, not the tires, the scooters. Yes. Steve Angelo getting mad because he went home from a party. Oh, someone said he was 2.5 hours too late. It was scheduled for earlier. Okay, I don't think it's the best choice to read out that entire chat. That Team Skullcap music or whatever is pretty fire though. That I have in the background from Glitch X, however you pronounce it. I cannot even talk, dude. Why can't you just forfeit P2? Give my man Steve a player. That bullet punch, nice chip. Let me break Sash, thank you. Dude, Colin has the same avatar that P2 has. I don't know why Mans changed his custom avatar into this guy. But I'm super glad that my internet didn't die yet, because I think it was 2 or 3 weeks ago. Yeah, it was the 1 week before the playoffs where my internet died. That shit was so annoying on the weekend. I mean, I don't want to jinx it. It can still die before this all-deciding game. That would be horrible. Or next all this, like every game is pretty much deciding now. And like scooters, just the Tigers just have to win that one game out of the next two to get it. Man said, don't really feel like forfeiting. I gotta go until 6 months at that. All 6 months at that.
Yo, Doc, you know you got 666 subscribers, right?
Yeah. 667, and then I lost one again.
Yeah, that's kind of scary, bro. I don't know. You better go pray or something.
Dude, I'm recording this Saw match, and it's turn 212, and my brain cells died, and I'm recording for like 70 minutes. The game is over.
What's the name of the game?
Huh?
I mean, who's playing?
Well, the name of the game. Well, is you was P2 versus S non-breaking stalls.
And the next match is gonna be Steve Angelo's ready, but his opponent is not here, so maybe.
No, that's gonna be such a good match.
Steve Angelo is
gonna be a great match.
The score is 4-6 now for the Tigers. If P2 loses.
Oh, it's 4-6.
Yeah, after this one.
Dang. So the scooters came back.
After this one, like it's 3-6 now, but P2 is losing this one.
Yeah,
like it's two more games.
Dang, P2 has lost.
This is awful stall, bro. I hate stall, but I mean it's stall, so I kind of feel bad for P2. I mean,
I'm pretty sure that I said it earlier in my video. I don't even know if it's Value's decision or if his manager like said you're bringing stall today, my friend.
No, because it's finals. I mean, you should have expected. They should have done like a freaking Hooper.
Not only because it's finals. I mean, Hooper gets trapped by Dougie.
True, yeah.
Unless you set shell, which is not that powerful if you don't have his specs.
Yeah, I like Band. Band plus something to get rid of Dougie, I guess.
I mean, maybe your own Dougie took rid of opposing Dougie, but that's still relying on speed tie, kind of.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe Pursuit Weavile, I don't know.
Yeah, Pursuit Weavile is pretty good too, but even then you're still risking.
I mean, Weavile just got swapped by Toxapex, kinda.
Yeah, Toxapex takes a lot of mons at the meta.
I mean, P2 is a fucking fighter. His ban has like flinched the Toxapex 12 times with the Greninja, but he didn't kill it. He was like some. Oh, he got the burn.
He got the heat wave burn.
Man's really fighting.
Oh, that's nice. I mean, I don't know, man. I don't know if P2's gonna win this. This is like, he's just taking on stuff.
When he lived once before Scald. They have like been spamming Scald earlier, never got burnt.
Yeah, I remember that.
Oh, have you been watching this game?
Watching. Yeah, I actually went first turn and watched the whole game.
Okay.
That's why I joined call. I was like, Doc's probably in call right now.
I recorded Black and White before this. It's already uploaded, but not publicly because I don't have the sound.
I hope you say go.
I don't know. He's using stall. Like, can't, you're not really.
He good. Wasted a will-o-wisp and hit a tornado.
So I mean that. Yeah. Always going Sableye on the rocks early. That does was some nice flex plays.
Yeah, I don't know. This game's over. Like, cause Willow has a rocks.
It's
and
been flex, over 220 turns ago. 200 turns ago. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Once we realized the Zygarde set, this game was over.
When the Zygarde was really jolly, it was annoying. But even if the Zygarde wasn't jolly, like he still could have like gotten it in range from Dougie to revenge it with Dougie anyway. Yeah, there's an ADV game, Ojama versus.
Why is he still fighting? Like I don't know.
Mean, he said he's not feeling. He doesn't feel like forfeiting.
Ojama
versus Jabba the Griffin, I think, is ADV. It's Gen 3, I have no idea, but I might record it because SBL is hype. I can't risk.
So, how many games are left then? Like, two more?
Jabba the Griffin versus Ojama, and the Song versus game? Steve Angelo, those two.
Alright, that's gonna be a good match. I can't wait for this game as well.
The thing is,
that's an SM,
the
SMOU,
thing is,
right?
If Ojama plays before the other game and. And like if the Scooters lose, like it's already over, and the Son versus Steve Angelo game might just be.
Oh yeah, that's a fact. Yeah, so.
I don't know if they will.
I mean, so
play.
It would just be for games for fun, like.
I don't think they will play because it's 1 AM in Germany and Steve Angelo is German. Because if it's just for fun, like he said he's gonna stay up.
To see, but I mean at this point, I don't even think.
It's he's staying up to like 5 AM. He said if he has to, but.
I don't know. I feel like it's pointless if they already lose.
But you mean if they have already won? Like he's on Steve Angelo's on a team that is winning. Like he might just say let's party all night if they already won it, and then he's like let's play this last game too. Because like Steve Angelo's team is up 6-4 the Tigers. P2 is counting down.
So let's go for 250.
Like, there was, like, some minutes where, like even now, I haven't even talked about the game. I was just talking about random stories, like, something.
Alright, so what if he crits the Chansey here? Oh, he didn't even.
Wait, which turn are you on? I'm turn 241.
I'm on
241. Oh, I was on 241. I was just letting the turns go by. I wasn't skipping them.
Okay, 242. I mean, he has no hurricanes left. He cannot even kill. Like, crit wouldn't kill the Chansey.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he was Inferno.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he just feels like making this game go longer, that's all. I like the the regenerator core, though.
Scarf, Scarf Rocks and Heligo, pretty cool.
This guy taunted.
Yeah, that sounds bad.
What is bad?
Scarf Rocks and Hill.
NJMP uses that. You just call NJMP bad. Good. Yeah, get the fuck out of here, dude. Just kidding.
I feel like you should only use that if you need a Volcarona counter and a rocker at the in the same slot and you only have one more slot left.
Yes, Steve Angelo.
The ultimate Volcarona counter. It gets rocks up and it still checks it.
Yeah, like I can understand why it's useful, gun. But I would never. Well, you could just use like Landorus or something. You can't necessarily beat Volcarona if it's like Roost or something. Defensive.
What the fuck? Why are they talking about that the game could be tomorrow?
What, Steve Angelo?
Yeah. Why would they?
Oh, that would be a
he
real.
He said ask the PS stuff. Ooh. Steve Angelo's ready. He wants a sub, but I think Steve Angelo was like out and it's complicated. He spoke to his friend CEB, who's the manager of the opposing team, and CEB's I don't know.
So like, is there any way that P2 could win this? Like, is there any possible
no.
way?
No. I mean, yeah, getting rid of his opponent's internet or something, but that's it. That's it.
Nah, not. I'm talking. I mean. That's kind of buns.
I mean,
I feel bad.
Like at this point,
I don't was think, a fighter. This whole SPL too.
Like I don't think you can choke at this point.
Yeah, it's not really. It's just a Tornadus.
Like, the Tornadus has no Hurricanes left. What is this gonna do?
Exactly. Like, all he has to do is go into Toxic Effect every time.
Nah, he doesn't even... It doesn't even matter. He can even sack his Dougie. Like, it doesn't... He can do whatever the fuck he wants.
Well, Dougies can still trap Toxic... His P2's Toxic Effect.
Yeah, but he doesn't have to. He can just do whatever he wants and he will win.
Pretty much, yeah. If he just keeps switching around and roosting and recovering and soft-boiling, whatever...
Like, chances are he could actually just win. Which is funny. Like, yeah. P2's Toxic Pex has, like, almost no scalds left, so Value's Toxic Pex kind of walls it. But Value's has no scalds and no recovers left. So it's just spamming Haze for ages now.
This is kind of a pathetic game to watch, I'm not even
sure. It's not pathetic, but it kills my brain cells. Man says, yeah, what? Like, this man just said, what do you think about 300? He's trying to bring it to 300 turns. Fuck off, dude.
Yeah, like, we understand that it's...
I know... You already showed that you're a fighter, it's okay. You can start.
Yeah, like, we get it. I feel bad. Because, like, he really wants this. Like, I know it's finals.
I mean, he knows that he, he knows that he can't win. He just doesn't want to forfeit. He said it in chat earlier.
Yeah. And, I mean, P2 had a pretty nice team, though. I'm not going to lie.
I'm going to go ahead and dip for a minute.
What?
Pizza doesn't really have a nice Scarf Lele counter, though.
I mean,
like, in my opinion, besides, I guess, Scarf Nihilego, he didn't really have a Scarf Lele counter.
Yeah, I mean, he has to, he has to predict perfectly between going Greninja on a Psychic and going Scissor / Toxapex on a Moonblast.
On Moonblast, yeah. But if it's an obvious switch, he could just go for HP Fire on the Scissor or Moonblast on the Grin or whatever. I guess it just matters how much he cares about his poisons.
God, can he stop spamming Haze?
Are you gonna uphold this whole game?
Of course, it's SBL Finals.
Yeah, I know. I mean, you uploaded. I remember that.
Stall was a stall for 2 hours and 30 minutes.
Yeah, I watched that whole thing. I'm like, yo, this is the most interesting game in the world. Two stall players really getting at it.
I also watched an ABR vs. Celly, but I only recorded 30 minutes of it. The ending, basically, and the beginning.
Yeah.
But I was up the entire night, like, for the game. The game was, like, 8 hours.
That's such a long game. Like, it's so... I don't know. It's not that I don't like Stall versus Stall. It's just, like, when it comes to recording...
I mean, ABR didn't have Stall. ABR didn't have Stall. Telly had some
fetch.
No, I
mean, like, in general, that, like, the Ubers game. The one...
Yeah, that one day I was just,
where
like...
Where it was, like, 2 hours.
I was just...
Yeah, I don't have a problem with it. I could watch it. It's just I don't like... You know, in terms of recording, watching it is like, ugh. But the game was interesting to me because, like, it just seemed like it would be something that. Because I read the comments and everybody was like going crazy around like the towards the end. So I was just like, yeah, I'm gonna watch this. If I wasn't reading the comments, I probably would have been like, all right, 30 minutes in, Stall versus Stall. I don't care if it's Uber Stall. I kind of hate OU Stall.
I mean, I was like. Kind of getting into Ubers because I don't know much about Ubers, so it's like a way for me to learn the tier. That's why also I wanted to record it.
Yeah, I like that you uploaded a little cup game. Like, I actually kind of enjoyed it. It's like mini OU a little
bit. I mean, it is, but my narration was hot ass.
Yeah. I mean, who cares? It's still like, I like low cup.
Because, like, someone called and in the background and I couldn't turn it off. And
no, to be honest, though, like, with the little cup though, little cup, like, they have weird like calcs, like,
you mean the damage the rules are,
the rules are like, it's like, say like you wanted to do an earthquake on, you know, I don't know, anything.
Oh, he said GG is over.
It'll do like 30 to finally, I think it's it'll over. Do like 30 to 60. It's weird.
I mean, they're still playing, but I'm probably behind.
Yeah. No, it's over. Game's over.
Yeah, but I'm behind. I'm still seeing Haze spam versus Spike spam.
Haze spam. Oh, what a game of Toxapex Simulator that was. Wow, that's funny. He just wanted 300. That guy must like the movies.
X. The Storm versus Steve Angelo's not happening. Hard
seriously?
X.
Oh my god.
I mean, I'm gonna have to eat something. This game is so long.
Yeah, I didn't expect the game to be that long. I knew it was gonna be long, but
it's like 95 minutes my recording.
Dang. Is OST going on to anything?
Yeah, PDC is playing pretty soon. I don't know if he's already playing. He's playing with a sub of mine, but I don't know if I still have power to record and if there's SPI at the same time. If the Ojama game is soon, I will record the Ojama game. I don't really care that I have no idea about Gen 3.
Yeah, I don't know a lot about Gen 3, like in terms of like the technicals, Ojama's, but like, I know a lot of the sets.
Ojama's Jesus, the god. Let me actually see which team Ojama is on after this. I'm at turn 259, still Haze versus Spikes.
Oh yeah. He ends it at 300, so.
Oh, he just wanted to reach the 300 mark and click
just,
X?
Yeah, he just wanted to reach 300 and click X, like, he was dead serious about it.
I mean, he could have reached 350 if he was like, or 330.
Yeah, if he really, really felt like
but
it.
At least try to go for 333.
Yeah, that would be nice too. I don't know, I just hate Stahl, bro. Like, it's only cool. I feel like Stahl's only cool when you're using it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, kinda.
Like, when you're actually, like, if you need it to ladder, like, say you need to get Rex or something, that's the only time Stahl is cool.
Yeah, so he finally forfeits. I'm turn 300 now. Let me click on this. So the score's 4 and 6, and. Ojama versus Jabba the Griffin is, in the scooters. Yeah, Ojama's on the scooters, and Jabba's on the tigers. Thank you guys for watching. This is gonna take us some hot hours to upload, some ages. I don't know if anyone watched until this point. Shoutouts to you. You can leave a comment. And thanks to my guests, we had at the beginning we had a Padlob in the video who left after like 30 minutes, I think. Then we had T for like almost the entire thing. Then we had Insult for like 10 minutes or so, and then he was like, nah, I'm not watching this. And then we have, what was your name again? Master Hawk?
Master Hawk, okay. Yeah.
So shout outs to you.
What's going on, guys?
Thank you for watching, and I don't know when the Ojama game is happening, but I will keep my eyes open, and I will record that. Peace out, friends.